like 20 years ago. So even though we have products now bigger than coffee, our favorite product, the one that we love the most, is coffee. Because thanks to coffee, we have a strong middle class in Costa Rica. Yes, sir?
How do you compare Colombia and you?
Well, both of them are excellent coffees. But there's countries that they have to work very hard to have a good quality coffee. And one of them is Costa Rica. Colombia is excellent too. Jamaica is excellent too. Because beans, in this case in Costa Rica, being a small country, we can compete with other countries in quantity. So that's why we have to look for the best qualities. And we will go through step by step what is what we have to do to have a gourmet coffee. But the thing is that thanks to coffee, we have a Costa Rica today that we are very happy to have. And it's that thanks to coffee, we have a middle class. Because as soon as the coffee arrived to this country, the government began to give out free land and free plants to the people that they were willing to have a coffee plantation. And that is how the middle class was born in this country. And it was a lot of work because for the first harvest, it takes around 3.5 to 4 years. How much land? That will be for you, Don Hutu.
This is only a garden for demonstration purposes, but the plantation is 15 minutes away from here. It's like 1,500 acres.
Little thing, huh? Yes, this garden that Don Jesus and Jorge have built, it's just to show to you how the plantation looks like. And they start with this, that we call it almácigo. And they have to plant that on the plantations. And they have to wait 2 years for the first harvest. So it's at first it's a lot of work, but then one of these coffee plants can keep on giving coffee for around 25 years or even more than that. For a gourmet coffee, we need several things. To start, we need a good plant. All the plants in Costa Rica, and this is the only country that has proof that we have 100% Arabic coffee. That is the first thing for a gourmet coffee. Second thing that we need is the altitude. Our buyers, they are now so strict that they even come with GPS to see the altitude of the plant to see if it reached to 900 meters and over. That would be around 3,000 feet. That would be gourmet coffee. For example, the people from the United States, all of you from the United States, except two of you that are from Canada, many years ago, you used to drink just any coffee. Now you have turned into gourmet coffee drinkers, right? Now you're very strict about the coffee that you drink. That's why United States is a market for us now on these days.
We sell it
to United States. In this case, well, and a lot of our coffee goes to Europe. That was since the first moment our market.
Roughly 70% of the Costa Rican coffee goes to Starbucks.
Oh, yeah.
We are stocking Starbucks. Yeah.
But this is a new market. 30 years ago, now you're our biggest buyer.
How tall do you want to get? Three.
Like this?
We don't want to let it grow too high because otherwise
it will
be too hard.
To pick by hand, exactly. So all these plants are Arabica. So we need then a good altitude, a good plant. We need volcanic soils, dry in the rainy season. Those are mainly the things for a gourmet coffee. Besides that, we have to pick the coffee by hand, bean by bean. By hand, that's a lot of work. There are other countries that they have invent machines. I have never seen one of those, but what I have is one that it's like a vacuum that pulls the beans, other ones that shakes, that damage the plants, and the quality will go down. Because they have to use these kind of baskets that you see over here. They have to attach this to their waist with this kind of a belt, and they're gonna start picking coffee, and they have to pick just the ripe beans. And they have to visit that plant several times, 2 or 3 times, come back when those green ones are ripe, and come back when those last ones are ripe. So it is a lot of extra work to have a gourmet coffee. The people will use this kind of hat that we call a chanete, so they can protect themselves against the sun, but at the same time, because the material that they are made of, this will keep their head very fresh at the same time. And these are the original baskets that our people used to use. Now these days I have seen they use plastic baskets too. These people have lunch on the fields, and they usually bring lunch in something like this. They can put their coffee in here, their food back there. I have seen that even though they use thermos, a lot of our people still, they like to bring the food wrapped in plantain leaves. This will give a special flavor and aroma to the food. And I have talked to the people that work in plantations, because it's not an easy job at all. It's a lot of work. But if you talk to them, they just love it, especially women. They can bring their children can play while they're working. They usually will be at the side of their friends, so they can pick coffee and chat for hours. So it is a good job. They pay around $1.50. ¿Cuánto está pagando aquí? $1.50? Per basket, never by weight or by hour. It's dependent on the quantity of coffee they will pick, the quantity of money they will get.
How many can they pick a day on
a good picker can make 25. I don't know if you have remember they used to make a contest in Costa Rica, and they even, the faster pickers, they will get a small house and things like that. They good prices. So how much on the last years, they still make over 25 baskets?
The record was 26, but normally a good picker would pick between 16 and 18, which is a lot. A lot of picking and a lot of hour working. One important issue here is that in Costa Rica we have fair trade. We don't allow kids to work. So by law, that's forbidden. These plantations and this mill, it's fair trade and ecology friendly. We don't dump anything into the river, we don't dump anything into nature. So we process everything and we recycle.
What's the minimum age to work?
16, 18 years old. Once they finish schooling is...
You actually have a 16 or 18 year old who would want to work.
During the coffee season, starts in early here, because depending on the area that we're talking about, some places start earlier, even September. But the peak will be from November till February, and this from December till February, we have the school vacation. Uh-huh. And some of the children want to make money for December, right? So they can buy presents for their family. Besides that, they love it. Sí, señor.
It's a piecework kind of thing. You pay by the basket. How do you maintain, make sure that I'm only picking the right beans and so forth?
We have supervisors by roles. So we assign 10, 15 people to one supervisor, and he makes sure that nobody's breaking branches or picking green coffee. Aside from the fact that if you're picking green coffee, you will be fired.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there will be always some green beans that will fall in there, but the idea is to pick, besides that they're going to fill the basket faster because the ripe beans are bigger. So, and the idea is that they, remember we're looking for quality.